From the start, the hill is practically straight. Then there's a left-hander, followed by a curving right-hander to the finish. But the conditions today were not really conducive to fast times. Control of the meeting is in the hands of a dedicated band of volunteers. It is not the easiest job in these conditions. Tony Marsh comes to the line. And Cotterill prepares for his run. Rivers Fletcher is chained down by Bellamy into the Ford Pop. And that little tent in the trees becomes very popular. This is a fine time to rebuild, Mr. Cotterill. Somehow a hat seems to do something for one, don't you think? Will Cotterill be ready on time? Stay tuned for a further installment. Wet conditions do not favour the high-powered machines. The key lock is not hanging about. Finish line on the bend is quite tricky. Bill Moss talks ERAs with Jim Berry. He takes advantage of a drying track to put in a fast run. And now we have great pleasure in presenting Mr. Cotterill. Tony Marsh up the hill. And just holds it on the finish. David Good, who won here last year, really gets his foot down in his bid for fastest time of the day. And it's fastest so far. But David Boshier Jones pulls out all the stops with a scorching run. And yes, he's done it, fastest time of the day. And as the cars return to the paddock, we take our leave from Westbrook Hay for another year. Oh no, not still at it.